Hey YouTube, this is MindTech. Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to set up Restream.io to work with OBS or XSplit, and I'm also going to be going through the features and the capabilities that this service has to make your streaming experience on multiple platforms as easy as possible. So without any further ado, let's jump right in. So the first thing I'm going to do is show you how to get it set up. First of all, go to your web browser and search up Restream, and Restream.io will be the first link right up at the top. Then you have to make an account. All they need is your email address, a username, and a password, which is pretty nice. And then once you get into Restream.io, all you have to do is press this add a channel button, and you have options to choose up to 50 different channels. With a free account, you can only choose up to 2 channels, but I'll discuss kind of the pros and cons of their pricing scheme later on in this video. So I'm going to choose to use Mixer, click the Connect Mixer Up button. Now I do recommend that you are already signed into Mixer, Twitch, or YouTube. If not, you're going to have to sign in right at this step, but since I am already signed in, I'm going to click on approve. And now that I have this channel added, I'm going to click on the add another channel button and click on Twitch. And now it wants me to sign in, give it my Authy token. It is a big hassle trying to log into the service right here. And then authorize Twitch again. The permissions that it needs is to be able to control like your stream titles. It manages your entire dashboard so that you don't even have to log on to Twitch or Mixer. Now we have to focus on this streaming settings section of the website right here. This is the information that we need to plug into OBS so it knows where to actually stream to. Instead of streaming to Twitch or to Mixer, we're basically going to be streaming to a Restream server. Then that server is going to push out the feed to the different platforms. So now you're going to need to launch OBS and go into the settings where you see the service drop down. Click on that and then go to where it says Restream.io RTMP. Click on the Use Stream Key button, copy the stream key that you see right here, and paste that into the stream key section. Now, if you don't see Restream in this list, all you have to do is click on custom for the service, and where it says server, copy this RTMP URL and paste that into the server box. Do the same thing with the stream key, click on apply, and now you should be set up to get your stream up and running with Restream.io. There are a lot of different features that this offers, and it really has two different audiences of people. The people that use OBS and XSplit and composite everything on their end, or the people that want to composite everything on the Restream.io website and not have to worry about having a local program installed. I do everything with OBS, so I'm only going to show you how I set up my stream with Restream.io. So first of all, in this section, I like that you can actually turn off and on the different services. If you only want to stream to Mixer, let's say, you can turn Twitch off, or if you want to do like a test stream just to see if everything is working, you can turn both of them off. And then if you click on the update titles button, if both Twitch and Mixer says that it has a test stream. If I go to Mixer and look at the stream title, as you can see, it says test stream. And another thing I like about this is you can edit each of these platforms independently just by clicking the edit button next to the service. So if on Mixer, let's say instead of streaming Minecraft, I wanted to stream a Mixer specific category like IRL, I can find that right there. I can even go and edit the title independently here, click on update again. And now these have two different categories, but the stream is still going to work on both of those platforms. If I go back to Mixer, as you can see, it took that title and it also took the category. Now, if you go on to the next tab, social alerts, I've kind of had some issues with this service in the past. It works most of the time. Now, first of all, I think that it's really nice how you can connect up your accounts. All you have to do, log on to Discord, Twitter, and Facebook, enter in that authentication code. And now that is logged in, it took my profile picture and my name automatically. And I'm also going to connect up my Discord account. So right now, Discord is going to allow Restream to change things like my username, my avatars, and be able to post messages on their bot's behalf. But Discord will not allow Restream to record a mixtape. If you have a service recording a mixtape for you, that might really offend someone. So now I'm going to select the server that I want to add the bot to, give it permission to read and send messages to be able to notify people on Discord when I've gone live, and I have to do the captcha. I think that's good. Now I can select the chat that I want it to go onto, and then in the message text, this is the same thing that's going to go out to all the different platforms. And that's the only problem that I really have with this, because on Discord, you might want to add everyone for an announcement. Whereas on Twitter, if you're adding everyone, someone with the name at everyone is going to be really annoyed while you're mentioning them. So I still recommend going onto these different platforms and sending out your notifications independently. But just for test's sake, I'm going to say this is a test. If I click on update, it should not be sending out any notifications right now. If I go onto my Twitter, as you can see, there are no tweet notifications. And if I go to my Discord mod chat, as you can see, there are no other notifications also. So the instant I go live, it will send out this notification. And that's one other reason why I don't really recommend using this. If you accidentally go live on OBS, it will still send out this notification to all your social media people. If you have this for an older stream, let's say, people are going to think that you're doing something that you've already done. And before I go live, I'm going to go through the different pages that Restream has, which I think are pretty cool. So like I said in the beginning, this is if you want to really composite your own stream, but that's something that I'm just not that interested in. What I do want to look at, though, is this page right here. What this does is it allows you to send a message universally across all of your different chats. It says that it is sent on both Twitch and on Mixer. So you can see on Twitch, which I have this is a test, and on Mixer I have this is a test. And even if I say something in Mixer chat and then I go to Twitch and say something in Twitch chat, I have that notification from both Mixer and Twitch chat. This means that you don't have to have two different chat windows open or 50 or however many different streams you're doing. You just have to have one. And the only other thing that's really important for me when I'm doing my streams is the analytics page. And this is because it gives an aggregate between all the platforms that you're streaming on, and it even tells you which platforms are more popular. So if I go the all sessions, it separates out all of your streaming sessions into different dates. So I can go to the one that I did a few weeks ago, and I can look at what audience came from where. It was literally half and half between Twitch and Mixer. Basically, all this different data that you can normally get from Twitch and from Mixer. But again, I don't have to even go to those pages to view my data. I can just see it all right here, which I think, again, is a pretty darn useful feature. And finally, they have a scheduler. This is if you want to post videos and stream them live. If you're a company trying to use Restream.io to make promotional content, this is something that you might want to use. But for me, I have never used this feature and probably will never use it. All right, so to specifically go into each plan, if you want to stream to like 30 or 40 different platforms, if you want to pay $20 a month, it allows you to stream up onto 3 platforms at once. And it also gives you more enhanced access to the on-site stream composer, which again, if you're using OBS, there isn't really any reason to use that. If you want to pay $50 a month, it allows you to do many different destinations. It says 3 extra, and it gives you the ability to remove the Restream branding from the on-site video compositor. Because if I quickly show you the live studio, as you can see, it says right up here, powered by Restream. So again, I honestly don't see a reason why you need to upgrade. I've done multiple streams already with this, just on the free plan, and I haven't had any reason at all why I need to give them a cent. But now I'm going to go and press the start streaming button on OBS, right on this Restream dashboard. It is receiving a feed from OBS. It finally just loaded in, and it tells you information like your frames per second, your resolution, your bitrate. And right here on the side, it tells us whether or not we're online on each platform and how many viewers we have. So it looks like it's still having troubles establishing a connection with Twitch, but we are already on Mixer. So if I pop on over to Mixer, it says that I have started my broadcast, and there we go. Here is my broadcast. And now if I go back to Twitch, now it has started again. It did also apply that test stream title. And now if I go on over to Twitter here, as you can see, my last tweet is the one that I put in the stream notification box. And if I pop on over to my Discord mod chat, it looks like it's still kind of having troubles adding it onto my server. So, you know, like I said, it isn't perfect with the notifications, but I am getting both streams up and running right here. If I put them side by side and click on play, they aren't exactly in real time, but I do have both streams running at the same time. And if I open up my dashboard right here, it is basically the same video that I have on both of these. There is a bit of a delay, but that's just because we are using 3 servers right now. So I think that as low latency as it is right now, that is still an incredible accomplishment on Restream's part. So with that said, guys, thank you for watching this video. I think that Restream is a great service, and I will continue using it until Mixer dies. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll catch you all in the next video. Bye-bye.